ever looked up at the night sky and just, you know, felt that pull, that wonder about what else is out there? I mean, searching for life beyond Earth, it's not just sci-fi anymore. It's like this quest, right? And we're diving deep into it today.
It's a question that really gets to, like, the core of who we are, don't you think? Where we fit in this whole, like, massive universe. And the crazy thing is we finally have the tools to actually start looking for answers.
That's what I find so exciting. We're not, like, passively stargazing anymore. It's like we're talking about analyzing the atmospheres of planets that are, like, light years away. It's amazing.
Think about the James Webb Space Telescope, for example. It can, like, actually detect the tiniest traces of things like, you know, carbon dioxide, methane, even water vapor in those faraway atmospheres.
Those are what they call biosignatures, right? Like clues that could point to life.
Exactly. And while we haven't found, like, absolute proof yet, there have been some pretty interesting hints. Remember a few years back, all that buzz about possible phosphine in the atmosphere of Venus?
Oh, yeah. There were so many theories about what could be creating it. I think some scientists even suggested it could be a sign of, like, microbial life, right? Up in those Venusian clouds.
They did, yeah. But it's important to remember there could be other explanations, too. But that's what's so cool about this whole search. It makes us think about possibilities we never even considered before.
And it's not just those distant planets that have us hooked. We've got some pretty compelling candidates right here in our own, like, cosmic neighborhood, don't we?
Absolutely. Mars, for instance. We know it had liquid water on its surface once, and some recent missions have even turned up evidence of organic molecules, you know, the building blocks of life.
So even though we haven't found any Martians yet, just the thought that life might have existed there or maybe even still does somewhere underground is pretty mind-blowing.
Totally. And then you have the icy moons of Jupiter and Saturn, places like Europa and Enceladus. These moons have these massive oceans of liquid water, but they're hidden beneath their icy shells. The water might even be warmed by tidal forces.
I remember seeing those images of, like, plumes of water vapor shooting out from Enceladus. Scientists think those plumes could be carrying stuff from that hidden ocean, like, right out into space.
Yeah, exactly. Imagine if we could get our hands on that material. It could be like a window into a totally alien ecosystem, one that might change how we define life altogether.
Okay, so far we've been talking about microbial life, these tiny organisms maybe hiding in the clouds of Venus or swimming in the oceans of a distant moon. But what if we found something bigger, something more complex? What if we found intelligent life?
Now that's where things get really profound. Finding intelligent life beyond Earth wouldn't just be a scientific discovery. It would be like this huge philosophical earthquake.
Yeah.
It would force us to completely rethink our place in the universe.
Yeah, like suddenly we're not the only thinking beings in the cosmos. That would challenge everything we think we know about being human, wouldn't it?
Think of the questions we'd be wrestling with. How would their societies be organized? What would their values and beliefs be like? Could we even communicate with them?
And what about the impact on us here on Earth? Would it bring us together, facing this shared mystery? Or would it create, like, divisions and anxiety?
Those are the kinds of questions philosophers and theologians have been thinking about for centuries. And now we're facing the possibility that we might actually have to answer them, like, for real.
It's almost too much to process all the potential implications.
Yeah.
But even just thinking about it, it really opens up this whole new perspective on life, the universe, everything.
It does, doesn't it? It makes you realize how much we don't know, how much is still out there waiting to be discovered. And in a way, that's what makes this search so captivating. It's a journey into the unknown, a quest for knowledge that could completely transform our understanding of who we are and where we fit in this grand cosmic scheme.
And who knows what incredible discoveries are waiting for us just around the corner.
The universe is full of surprises. And honestly, I think we've barely scratched at the surface. But before we, you know, dive even deeper into those possibilities, let's take a moment to reflect on what we've explored so far.
Yeah, we've covered a lot, from the cutting-edge science of searching for those biosignatures to the mind-bending philosophical implications of finding intelligent life.
We've talked about planets with hidden oceans, the possibility of microbial life in the clouds of Venus, and just the sheer vastness of a universe that could be teeming with life, both familiar and utterly alien.
It's enough to make your head spin, but in the best possible way.
It certainly is. And when we come back, we'll delve into some even more mind-blowing concepts, like the idea that we might not be alone in time, you know, that there could have been civilizations that rose and fell long before our own even began.
Now that's a thought-provoking concept. We'll be back soon to unravel the mysteries of cosmic time and what they might reveal about our own place in this grand cosmic narrative. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to our exploration of life beyond Earth. Before the break, we were talking about the crazy implications of finding intelligent life out there.
Mm-hmm.
But even if we, never bump into another advanced civilization, the search itself has led to some amazing insights. You'd agree with that, right?
Oh, absolutely. And one of the most, I think, profound things it makes you realize is just the sheer vastness, not just of space, but of time, too.
Okay, now I'm really intrigued. How does time, factor into the search for life beyond Earth?
Well, when we look at the stars, we're not just seeing things that are incredibly far away. We're looking back in time, too.
Because it takes so long for the light from those stars to actually reach us, right?
Exactly. The light from some of those, super distant galaxies, it's been traveling for billions of years. So the images we see, they're snapshots of those galaxies as they were billions of years ago.
So it's almost like we have a time machine, in a way. We can actually observe the universe as it was way back when, in its early stages.
Yeah, in a sense. And that means that somewhere out there right now, there could be civilizations that have already risen and fallen, whole cosmic stories that have played out even before our planet was even formed.
Wow. That's a pretty humbling thought. I mean, we tend to think of ourselves as the peak of evolution. But what if there were civilizations way more advanced than us billions of years ago?
It's definitely a possibility. And even if we, never actually find any direct evidence of these, ancient civilizations, just knowing they could have existed, it changes our perspective, don't you think?
It totally does. It makes our own history, our struggles and triumphs seem a little less, significant, I guess, in the grand scheme of things.
And yet at the same time, it makes the fact that we're here now even more amazing. We're a part of this huge ancient story, and it's a story that's still being written.
Yeah, it's awe-inspiring and kind of terrifying all at the same time. But thinking beyond the philosophical side of things, what about the practical impacts? Has the search for, alien life affected our lives here on Earth?
Absolutely. I mean, space exploration has pushed for incredible advancements in technology, and those have tons of applications here at home, everything from satellite communication to medical imaging. The pursuit of knowledge beyond our planet, it's had this ripple effect that's improved our lives in so many ways.
That's a good point. It's a reminder that even these really ambitious, out there scientific endeavors, they can have real tangible benefits for us here on Earth.
Exactly. And don't forget the power of inspiration, The images of those distant galaxies, the stories of human ingenuity and courage facing the unknown. It captures our imaginations. It reminds us what we're capable of.
It sparks that sense of wonder and curiosity that's so important for us to keep moving forward.
And it encourages us to think beyond our own little bubble, to think about our place in the universe,
Yeah.
To ask those big questions about who we are, where we come from, and where we might be going.
Speaking of those big questions, we've talked about finding microbial life, maybe even intelligent civilizations, uh-huh. But what about colonizing other planets? Is that even something that's possible?
Well, people are definitely thinking about it seriously. With all the progress in space travel and technology, the idea of setting up human settlements on Mars or even further out isn't just sci-fi anymore.
Wouldn't that open up a whole bunch of ethical questions, too.
For sure. Do we even have the right to go and change other planets to fit our needs? What impact would humans have on any, native life that might be there?
Those are definitely questions we need to be thinking about now, way before we even take those first steps toward becoming a multiplanetary species.
And it's not just about, the ethics of colonizing other planets. It's also about what kind of future we want to build. Do we want to just copy the same systems and problems we have here on Earth? Or do we want to use this as an opportunity to build something better, something more sustainable and fair?
It's a chance to rethink our values, learn from our mistakes, and build a future that actually lives up to humanity's incredible potential.
Yeah, exactly. And all of this, the scientific exploration, this deep philosophical thinking, it's all driven by this one core human trait, curiosity. That constant desire to know, to understand, to push the boundaries of what's possible.
It's that same curiosity that drives us to explore the oceans, the mountains, even the farthest reaches of space.
And it's that same curiosity that makes us question our place in the universe, To think about the meaning of life and search for connection with something bigger than ourselves.
It's like we're on this incredible journey of self-discovery.
Yeah.
And it's driven by the same force that powers the stars. And even if we don't ever find, absolute proof of life out there, this whole quest is still super meaningful.
It really is. It's deepening our understanding of the universe, it's pushing the limits of human knowledge, and it's making us think critically about our values and what we want for the future. In a way, the search for life beyond Earth is also a search for ourselves.
It's about figuring out who we are, where we come from, and where we fit in this grand cosmic picture.
Precisely. And who knows what amazing things are waiting for us, both out there in the vastness of space and within ourselves. But before we go any further into those uncharted territories, let's pause for a moment and gather our thoughts.
Yes, we have covered so much today, from the mind-blowing scale of cosmic time to the ethical challenges of, like, becoming a multiplanetary species.
But there's one more layer to this whole exploration, one that goes beyond the search itself and into what it all means for us right here, right now.
That's where things get really interesting. When we come back, we'll explore how the search for life beyond Earth isn't just about finding them, it's about understanding us. Stay tuned.
Welcome back, everyone. It's been quite the journey so far, hasn't it? This whole idea of searching for life beyond Earth, it really makes you think.
It does, doesn't it? It's like we've touched on the science, the philosophy, but now I think it's time to bring it back to us, you know? What does it all mean for us here on Earth right now? You mentioned this idea that searching for alien life, it's like we're searching for ourselves too. Can you break that down a bit more for us?
Well, just think about it. The very act of searching, it forces us to really define what we even mean by life. We have to open our minds to all sorts of possibilities, right? Life forms that might be totally different from anything we've ever seen.
So it's like challenging those assumptions about, you know, what life is, where it can exist, what it might even look like.
Exactly. And in doing that, it helps us appreciate the incredible diversity and resilience of life, you know, right here on our own planet. It also highlights how interconnected everything is, like even on a cosmic scale.
It's like zooming way out to see the bigger picture. We're not just individuals, not even just earthlings, but part of this vast, like interconnected web of life that could stretch way beyond our planet.
Exactly. And that realization, it has huge implications for how we treat each other, how we take care of our planet, you know, how we approach the future.
Earlier, you mentioned how we answer certain questions now. It could foreshadow how we might react if we ever actually found alien life. Can you talk a little more about that?
Okay, let's imagine we actually make contact with another intelligent civilization. How do we approach them? With curiosity, a desire to learn, or are we met with fear, competition?
I get what you're saying. Yeah, I mean, our history is filled with examples of how we treat those who are different, right? Different cultures, different species, even each other.
And that's exactly why this whole search is so important, even beyond the scientific discoveries. It's like a mirror, reflecting back our own values, our biases, our potential for both good and bad.
So it's a call to action then, a reminder to become more aware of our limitations, to cultivate compassion and understanding, not just for humanity, but for all life, wherever it might be.
That's a great way to put it. It reminds us that the search for life beyond Earth, it's not just about finding them, it's about understanding us.
This whole deep dive, it's been amazing, full of, like, wonder, new insights, even a bit of soul searching. I think I'm going to be thinking about these things for a long time.
Me too. It's a topic that never gets old, always sparks the imagination, challenges our perspectives. Who knows what incredible things we'll discover in the years to come.
If you're listening and your mind is buzzing with thoughts, questions, we want to hear them. Share your reflections, your hopes, your fears, whatever this exploration has sparked in you.
And remember, this search for life beyond Earth, it's a journey we're all on together. So keep looking up, keep asking questions, and never lose that sense of wonder.
Thanks for joining us on this deep dive. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And until next time, keep exploring the wonders of this vast and mysterious universe we call home.